אוקיי, מורי ורבותיי, אנחנו מציינים ערב שבת קודש, שבת פרשת בהר, מייתן שברור עולם, מייתן לכל אחד ואחד מכם long life and a healthy life and a happy life and we fulfill all your wishes in the greatest way possible ונאמר אמן. Ladies and gentlemen, today we're going to share, before we're going to start the parasha, maybe one message from the parasha, but just before, I will tell you something. חזל said, כדאיו רבי שמעון, is a statement that we all use. בר יוחאי, נמשכת אשריך, שמן ססון מחבריך. Our sages have statements. And the statement said, כדאיו רבי שמעון, נסמוך עליו בשעת הדוחק. It's worthy רבי שמעון to count on him in time of need. What's the meaning? Why? Why so much that רבי שמעון said, יכול אני לפתור את העולם כולו מן הדין. I can examine the whole world from judgment. What exactly happened? What is the reason that we can count on רבי שמעון בר יוחאי in time of need? Today I'm going to share with you three reasons. The first reason is, Gabriel, listen to this, the first reason, they have an argument between the Jewish nation to God. Who's supposed to come to who? We're supposed to do teshuva first, or God have to bring us back first? We have to come back first to God, or God have to come to us first?
From where?
He said, Shuva elai, v'ashuva alechem, is a pasuk. Come back in teshuva, and then I will give you everything that you wish. Everything that you need. Parnasa, Yeshua, Shalom Bayit, Yeladim, whatever you need, I will give you. Condition. Make teshuva. Shuva elai. Come back. Make a steps. Make a difference in your life. And then I will come to you. And we said, Ashivenu Hashem Elecha v'Neshuva. You're going to bring us back in teshuva. Ashivenu. You're going to bring us, and then we're going to make teshuva. You hear that? First of all, you. So who is right, Nadir? God or us? Come, Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai, and listen to what I said. The pasuk said, Ki ikach ish isha. Pasuk said in Kiddushin. Ki ikach ish isha. Mikan, Omer Rabbi Shimon, Mikan she'aish mechazer achar ha'isha, ve'en ha'isha mechazeret achar ha'ish. Who is chasing who? The man looking for the woman? The man is the one that proposes? The man is the one that going to chase? Or the woman? Who is the one? Gabriel, who is the one? Come the pasuk and said?
Ki ikach ish isha. But in our days, woman.
This is the chutzpah. This is the chutzpah, but in general.
I'm going to go to the minyan.
כי כך יש אישה מכאן שהאיש מחזר אחר אישה נדיר, אמן אהבתו כמשל למה הדבר דומה הברינג המשל a person lost items you lost a wallet, you lost money, you lost who is looking for you? The lost item is looking for you or you're looking for the lost item? So the woman is what? Tzela, the woman is a part of the body from the man, right? So the man lost his wife. Your job is to look for the lost items. This is what the Gemara said. For me, Chazal said,
Ay.
And Matan Torah, it was Kiddushin. The man considered to be Borei Olam. The wife is Knesset Yisrael. And the Torah is the Ketubah. Who is looking to who? A man after the wife? Or come, Rabbi Shimon and said, Amar Mikan Shehaish Mechazer Achar Ishto. From here, Allah said, Borei Olam after, meaning, God, why is important? Because the person said, you know what, Rabbi? The angel would come and said, why are you not religious? Why are you not religious? Why you don't keep Torah Mitzvot? Why are you in such a low level? Come, Rabbi Shimon said, I can be protect the whole world. Maybe that I didn't, from the judgment, why? A person who might be, is going to have answer. Why God didn't brought me anything that I need? Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai, if you're going to bring me anything that I need, Ashivenu Hashem Elecha, and then Veneshuva. Bring us back, bring us the blessing, open the gate of heaven, give us everything that we need, and then We're going to do a teshuva, spirituality. And this is what I said many times, that the Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh said, the Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh said, because of that, people blessing each other. Listen, Hasidim, they are the only one that bless in such a way. Usually, you're going to hear the regular world, the Litvish world, they will bless you. May God will bless you with Torah, with spirituality, and then physically. Right? Al shelo berchu b'Torah tchila, al machar v'Yerushalayim. Why Yerushalayim was destroyed? Because people bless each other. Parnasa, Yeshua, children, Balagan, everything except Torah. Torah they keep to the end. And also, you know, your children is going to be beautiful and smart and a doctor and a lawyer and a nachat. And then maybe to be Talmid. Kam Chazal said, Ashelo birchu b'Torah tchila. When you bless a person, you have to bless him in Torah first. And God will bless you to make teshuva. To be close to him. And then, automatically, Pranasa, Yeshua, Berakha, everything else. This is simple, Pirush. This is not simple, but this is the Pirush of the Litvish world. Come, Chassidut, and the Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh, and challenge this blessing. And listen to why. He said, Sheburu Olam Eten Lecha, Gashmiut, Berakha, Bageshem Uvaruach, Begashmiut Uvaruchaniut. You might going to ask me, Rabbi, what the Arab blessing? Why are you blessing Bageshem first? Why Gashmiut first? Why money? Why Shalom Bayit? Why children before Torah? From Torah everything. If you have Torah, you have everything. So why you bless him and everything? The Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh said, beautiful, and this is realistic. Tell me, can you invite a person to Shiur Torah when he doesn't have money to pay the rent? Or can he be focused when he have no money to pay food? Can he be sitting down in the Shiur and be focused? Very nice. The Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh said, in order that a human being will have good ruchaniyot, you need to have a comfortable life. Marbe nechassim, marbe da'aga, meaning da'aga is something that bothers you. Your head is not here. You're flying all over. We all know when we have a big deal, when we have a major, major deal that will change our life, when we have a major meeting, there's no one in the second floor, no one to talk. The guy's looking at you. He's maybe in the class. But he's looking at you and you see his eyes, it's a whole different world. If he doesn't have the rent and tomorrow the owner is supposed to throw him out to the street, how do you want him to be focused on you? So the Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh said, I will bless you with Gashmiut in order to lead you to Ruchaniut. But Gashmiut first. You see, what the Baal Shem Tov took it? From Avraham Avinu. Avraham Avinu is the first father. He represents Gmilut Chasadim. Yitzchak represents Tefillah. And Yaakov Avinu, Yaakov, Ishtam, Yishev, Onim represents Torah. Who is first, Avraham? And how exactly Avraham made teshuvah with people? He didn't come and teach Torah first. What Avraham Avinu did? V'hu Yoshev Petach Ha'oel, Achnasat Orchim. He used to give people to eat. And even the food, he never asked you before eating the food to make barakha. He gave you food. And when you came and you ask him, who to bless? I want to say thank you. He said, thank you to the Almighty God. And if you don't want, before you eat, you have to pay for the food. But you hear that? Through the food, through the physical, he made people. So this is what Rabbi Shimon said. Ama Rabbi Shimon kedai ani liftor et kol haolam min hadin. If God will come, will challenge, if the angel will come, midat hadin, will come against a human being, he's going to say, gentlemen, you know why? We don't keep Torah mitzvot. You know why? God, Ashivenu Hashem Elecha. Bring us back. Come back to us. Bring us back. You don't have to come. But open the door. Open the door.
Choose us.
Give us all the blessing, and then I guarantee you. What a beautiful name. And only Rabbi Shimon is the one that said. This halacha is from Rabbi Shimon. Ah, now that we are married, we know how it's important. A man have to choose his wife. Because of that, even tradition-wise, which place you get in marriage? If I really want to get married in a different place. The wedding. To make the wedding. I had a dream to make it next to my yeshiva. My wife wanted to make it in Kiryat Malachi. In which place we got married?
In between.
No, Kiryat Malachi. Why? Aish mechazer achar aisha. Ve'en aisha mechazeret achar aish. If the wife wants to get married in a certain place, you have to go the extra mile. Why? You have to. You're the one. You're the one. The wife. No, not only that. The wife is not the one that says, Are ani mekudeshet lecha. You're the one that says, Are at mekudeshet. You're here to sacrifice to me. You're here to become my wife. Why? The men have to make the move. Almighty God is the one. This is one explanation. Wow, הרי אני כדאי, כדאי אני לפתור. Second explanation, ladies and gentlemen, second explanation, nevertheless, once, I don't know if we ever spoke about it, but they saw, the Midrash right, the Midrash right. You know, how many years Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai stayed in the cave? For how many years? 13. How many years? What do you say? 13. What do you say, how many years? 12 years. He went after 12 years, and he saw two people working, working the field, working. There's many opinions if they're Rashaim or not, but they're working. And what Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai did? מניחים חיי עולם ועוסקים בחיי שעה. Today, the world is the opposite world. When you see a religious man, what do you say? Rabbi, how can you study Torah the whole day? What exactly happened to you? Why are you not working? Why אוכל חינם? And Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai just the opposite. You know what he said? How can you have business? How can you work? What the shame is to go back to the business? You're going to ask me, Rabbi, he said, מניחים חיי עולם. You live in eternal life. Eternal life, being the study, be connected to Torah, is eternal life. And you go into temporary life to make money, to buy cars, to buy a house. What's going on with you guys? You know what he did? He burned both of them in the spot. He made both of them shish kebab. He killed both of them to the ground. He made them. He got upset. Uh-huh. He went out and he got upset. He said, how can people walk? He didn't understand. 12 years. He's in the cave, learning Torah in the highest level. Achieving over there, he made the Zohar Kadosh. From that moment, he became Rabbi Shimon. And he's going out and he sees these people. What's going on with these people? Bat kol came from heaven. A voice from heaven came. And said, Rabbi Shimon, להחריב עולמי יצאת? You came out to destroy my world? Go back to the Meara. Go back to the cave. He went back into the cave for 1 year. The punishment of Hashem in Gehenna is how long? 1 year. He killed, you have to go into the cave. 1 year. After 1 year he went out and he saw a person that go with two adatsim, two bench. No, but the 12 years was not really b'chira ishit. The Caesar was looking to kill him.
So he ran away.
After the voice from heaven, some say, Eliyahu Navi, voice from heaven.
It's not,
yes, but still it's a punishment. To be away from his wife, away from his student, away from everybody, to be lonely. I don't think that he's never so comfortable to be lonely in this world. Thank God he had this child, it's the only reason. Thank God, but if not for that, to be lonely, to be in a small cave, 1 year. So listen to this. He went back to the Meara, and he went out of the Meara, and he saw one person take two bench of adasim, spices. And he said, why do you take two? Why not one? He said, one keneged zachor, one keneged shamor. It was Erev Shabbat. I'm taking it to respect Shabbat. Now, is any mitzvah, any halakha, any tradition? It's nothing. The guy came out with tradition. What Rabbi Shimon said? Ashrei Israel, how fortunate is the Jewish people that they take two bench. What the mitzvot, what the yukir of mitzvot, what the way of mitzvot, they're looking at mitzvot in a very high level, okay? Now, in a second, I'm going to ask you a few questions on these stories.
He was alone in the cave? Or he was
with his own son. Now, before I'm going to ask you this question, I'm going to tell you this one. The Midrash, right, listen what the Midrash, the Zohar Kadosh bring it to Israel. It was one day that Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai came out and he saw a ball of fire. Fire came out. Angel, a ball of fire is coming from heaven to the world. And he said, excuse me, I see the angel is coming with the fire, huge. So, excuse me, what do you do? He said, I came here to destroy the world. He said, who told you to destroy? He said, I'm a messenger of the Almighty God. So Rabbi Shimon came Baruch Hai, told the angel, go back and tell God, Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai is here. There's no point to destroy the world. The angel is going back. 1 hour later, you see again the same angel with a ball of fire. He's coming back. Rabbi Shimon said, excuse me, what do you do? He said, I'm coming here to destroy the world. He said, I was not clear in the first time when I told you not to come. If I'm going to see you once again, I'm going to bore you completely. You're going to be the one that did, not the world. He said, but I'm the messenger. He said, no, I don't know. Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai is here. Go back and tell the Almighty God that I'm here. And as long as I'm here, nobody can destroy the world. He went back. And a voice from heaven came and said, Ashrecha Rabbi Shimon, Shealecha Omer HaPasuk, V'tzadik Yesod Olam. How fortunate Rabbi Shimon, that the Pasuk that said that the whole world stand on the tzadik, we're talking about you. You're the tzadik. How can you explain these two stories? Going back, go forward, tell God what God didn't know that Rabbi Shimon is here. The chidush, you're going against the will of God. Now I'm going to tell you the third story, and then we're going to wrap everything together. Chazal omrim. By the way, in the first story I have a question. And the question is this way. Why Rabbi Shimon born the guy that was working? Because he got to such a high level in spirituality, he got to such a level of Kedusha that he didn't understand. So why you send them back to the cave? Send them to Miami. Send them to a vacation. You send them back to the cave. He's going to become more Kadosh or less Kadosh?
More Kadosh.
So if before he didn't understand, after definitely not, right? Why you sending them to the cave? Send them to a vacation. Relax. Rabbi Shimon, you become too religious. You become too holy. Why God said, why the voice came and said, go back to the cave? Okay. In order to understand that, listen to the thought of the story. The third story said this way. Racham, listen to that. It was once, the Gemara said, 80 talmidim ayu lo lilel hazaken. Lilel hazaken had 80 students. The smallest one is Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai. The biggest one is Rabbi Yonatan ben Uziel. And what was so special about Rabbi Yonatan ben Uziel, the grave of Amukah, that every time he used to study Torah, a fire used to come and burn any board. Any board that passed through, a fire was born in. Now, the Chiddush Harim is asking the questions. This is when the students study Torah. When Hillel HaZaken study Torah, what exactly happened? What exactly happened then? And his answer is this way. Hillel HaZaken, when he studied, he had a fire. But the fire was low. Meaning, the fire didn't burn nobody. When Rabbi Yonatan ben Uziel was studying, a student, the greatest student, the fire get all the way to heaven. Any board that passed through was burning. When Hillel HaZaken was studying, the fire was low. Why? The difference between a student to a rabbi is, a rabbi have the ability to control his precious passion, his motion. A student not. You heard that? Now we understand why God told Rabbi Shimon, go back to the cave. You know why? When he went after 12 years and he started to burn people, God told him, you're still a student. You don't have the power to control the fire. Go back for another year. Become a rabbi. You see, people that they are over, what is that? Ma ben talmidav le talmidav. The student of Avraham Avinu to Bilam HaRasha. The student of this and the student. Why? Student cannot control themselves. They are full of fire. But a rabbi can consume the fire. Beautiful. Now we understand. A rabbi have ability to have Rashaim next to him and still find a way to get them closer. A rabbi have the ability to be in a synagogue and to see some people talking and still be there, make the minyan, and later on teach them slowly how not to speak during the tefillah. Some students that don't have the ability, you speak, get out of here. Right away they react. Why? The fire is still on. Now we understand the explanation. Rabotai, when God sent this angel to destroy the world, Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai said, dear angel, tell him I'm here. What's mean I'm here? When I want to destroy the world, what God told me? You cannot be a student. You have to be a rabbi. And being a rabbi, you see in simple people and get excited. He sent me back to study. Tell God, you cannot be a student. I, in my life, prove that life is not about black and white. It's a lot of gray area. You cannot destroy it. I also want to destroy the world. And the Almighty God is the one that stopped me from destroying the world. He said, "L'achiv olami yatzata," go back to the cave. Now we understand why he told the angel Rabbi Shimon is here. In life, we have to understand that it's not always black and white. It's a lot of gray area. In our life and in the general life, when you come and you judge yourself, don't judge yourself either Gehenom or either Gan Eden. It's a lot of gray area. As long that you're going higher and higher, as long that you're mit'aleh b'kdusha, you're in the right path. Come Rabbi Shimon and said, as long that I'm here, I can teach you that there's a lot of gray area. This is the second thing. כדאי הוא רבי שמעון בר יוחאי, לסמוך עליו בשעת הדוחק. But there's another reason. Another הלכה, why רבי שמעון have the ability to save all of us מדינה של גיהנום. You know that Purim and Lag BaOmer always falling down in the same day? This year, which day was Purim? Wednesday night. Why Wednesday night? Because Wednesday night it was Lag BaOmer. They call it Peleg. מה זה Peleg? Pei, Purim, Leg, Lamed Gimel BaOmer. You're going to ask me, what's the connection between Purim and Yukur? What's the connection? Okay, simple connection is happiness. In both times we're happy. Simple connection. Simple connection is that we are both happy. But it's much deeper connection. You know, Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai said, another halakha, listen to this halakha. Shikor, a person that is drunk, you cannot judge him for his action. He is exempt from anything. A person that is drunk, a regular in a civil court, if you're going to drive drunk and you're going to kill a person, they're not going to only judge you. They're going to put you in the bar forever. Drunk is the worst. Come Rabbi Shimon and said, Shikor Patur, a drunk person is exempt from anything else. And this is the reason in Purim, we drink. Why? If we're going to have judgment, if Mashiach is going to come, if we're going to have in the moment, said God, Shikor Patur. Maybe I'm not so spirituality. Maybe I'm not so religious, but Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai is the one that said that Shikor, a drunk man is exempt from any judgment. So I'm exempt. Now what's the connection to Lag BaOmer? Very simple. Gentlemen, a drunk is not only from wine. A drunk meaning a person that is mind in tefir, that is not in focus. When a person have no money to pay the rent, when a person have one of the family members have a sickness, a cancer, when a person have suffering in Shalom Bayit, when a person have suffering in Beriyut, when a person have suffering in the job, he is a drunk man. You cannot blame him for his action. He's not in focus. Kedayu Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, Yismuch Alav, when? B'Sha'at HaDochak. B'Sha'at HaDochak meaning in the suffering moment. In a difficult moment. Why? Because in the difficult moment, God, you cannot judge me. Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai said, I am exempt. Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai is the only one that said that a drunk person is exempt. Ay, 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 it's three reasons. Why? And every time that a person has obstacle, and every time you have something, an important meeting, important dates, and for anything important in your life, what do you have to do? Tradition-wise, you light two candles. One, Lezecher Nishmat HaTzadik, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai.
Any time.
Kedayu Rabbi Shimon Nismuch Alav B'Sha'at HaDochak. In time of need, Rabbi Shimon is the one that is worthy to count it. And the second one is Rabbi Meir Balanes, but this is a different topic. Rabbi Meir Balanes, if you're going to light these two candles for Lezecher Nishmat HaTzadikim, זכותם תגן עלינו, then you're going to see miracles in your life. And why? Because when you're going to be saved from redemption, when you're going to be saved from our exile, Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai is going to be the one that will stand for us, בעזרת השם, to take all of us from the galut to גאולה, from exile to redemption, ובניין בית המקדש, וכן יהי רצון ונאמר אמן.
אמן.